So we have studied E plane T as subtractive, but if you take in case of H plane T, it is additive. And you have here also two arms, arm 1 and 2 as collinear arms, and arm 3 as side arm. And you have this is form, this is of the shape which is shown in the figure. And you have this is called, or the other one, E plane T is a series part of it, and this is a parallel junction. And so we have to see that the previous E plane T, we have seen that it is opposite in phase, but here it will be in phase. So there will be no negative symbol when you are doing it. So you can just note down these things. I will show you the equations and the characteristics further. So you can just write down H plane T. And the H plane T junction is formed when the rectangular slot is cut along with the along the width of the long waveguide, and the side arms are attached to the slot. So this is how the shape of the T junction, which is called as H plane T, will be of. So we'll look into little more detail with the characteristic equations and the metrics for S for H plane T. So once you complete drawing this figure, just let me know that, then I will proceed further. So you should be clear with the diagrams when you draw. Don't just write, if E plane is asked, don't write H, and when H is asked, don't write E. Most of the students make mistake of that type. They don't see that which plane T it is, and or they get confused and they write in a different answer for the question. So you should be very much careful when you're writing E plane and H plane. So H plane looks like this. So E plane is subtractive and H plane is additive. The other one is series, this one is parallel. So these are some of the things. So you draw this figure. See, inform your friends that attendance is very much important. You can't skip the attendance like that. So if it is completed, just tell me that it is completed, then I can proceed further. You have completed drawing that figure. Have you completed?
Yes.
Yeah, complete it, then we'll move further. Is that over?
No.
See, once it is completed, at least inform me, okay? So that I will proceed further. So you need to Try drawing this figure. It's easy to draw when you have this box placed here, and then you draw these lines, and you can draw further.
Finish, sir.
Okay. So so we'll see that these are the points which we have discussed here. That is, when you take in an H-plane T, if the two input waves are fed at port 1 and 2, so in the input ports will be port 1 and 2 and of the collinear arm, and the output port will be port 3. Okay. So we'll be at port 3 and will be in phase. This is very important, in phase additive. These are the two things which is important for H-plane T, that is at port 3 you will be having in phase and it will be additive. The other one is out of phase and it will be subtractive. So in H-plane T we have the system in phase and it is additive. So the port 3 is called as sum arm. Also the port 3 is equally divided into port 1 and 2 in phase and the magnitude. So here in the previous case we have taken negative symbol here, but since it is in phase you will be having S31 is equal to S32. So since port 3 is perfectly matched to the junction, when microwave power is fed into port 3, nothing comes out of port 3, so as reflection, and that's the reason we can write S33 is equal to 0. So last time we also wrote S33 is equal to 0. Here as well, in this we have S33 is equal to 0. So once you understand E-plane T clearly, so to understand H-plane T is very simple. Only thing is that a small negative symbol change. In that it will be minus, here it will be plus. That is because it is in phase, the other one was out of phase. That is a small change. Rest of the things remains the same. The process of doing the everything, matrix, everything remains the same. So it becomes easy for you. And here also you have the symmetric property. So Sij will be equal to Sji. So you can just note down these important things and we will write the S matrix for that. So here you have to understand that S31 is equal to S32. Why? Because it is in phase, and since there is no reflections from the junction, so S33 is equal to 0. Symmetric property for S parameters is applicable. So we can write Sij is equal to Sji. So all the things you can put it in the matrix, and you can just rewrite the matrix of S parameter, S11, S12, S21, all those things in by using all these three things, that is S31 is equal to S32, S33 is equal to 0, and Sij is equal to Sji, as you have done in E-plane T as well. So you can complete it. So all of you can complete it. Write the S matrix as well. So the S matrix will be rewritten as S11, S12, S13, S12, S22, S13, S13, S13 and 0. So all of you will get the matrix S in this form. Our process which we have done in E-plane T, the same process we have to do in H-plane T as well. We have to take the S and S conjugate, and that is equal to a unitary matrix, and we have to find the equations and solve it further to find out all the parameters like S11, S12, S13, S12, S22, S13, S13, S130. So we have to substitute these values in this matrix and say that this matrix stands for H plane T. So that is the procedure, same procedure as that of the previous E plane T. Only change is, you can see that there is no negative symbol available here. It is in phase component, so S31 is equal to S32. Rest of the things are same. So here I have already mentioned that why we are writing all these things, because S21 is equal to S12 because Sij is equal to Sji, S23 is equal to S32, same reason, and S32 is equal to S31, it's already there in the equation below before, and S31 is equal to S13 because of the symmetric property Sij is equal to Sji. Previous class all of you have completed till here, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so same way how you have done for E plane T, the methodology is the same. Only thing is that here the negative symbol is not there. Rest of the things, the process of doing it is the same process what we did for E plane T. So let us just substitute this values and then this matrix and then just move ahead. So what we have to do here is, from unitary property, you know that S multiplied by its conjugate is a unitary matrix. So I have just put both the matrices here, S and its complementary matrix, that is equal to 1 0 0 0 1 0 and 0 0 1. So all of you can just write down that. Now we are going to get the equations and we need to solve the values for all those things which is unknown for you, S11, S12, S13, S12, S22, S13, and we will be substituting these values here, and we will find out that what is the S matrix representation for H plane T. So this is what you can see here. So all of you can just substitute the matrix for S and S conjugate and the U matrix, unitary matrix. And now we are going to write the equations for that. So since you have studied the E plane T, the same process we have to do here as well. You have to write the equations and solve the values for S11 and S12 as well as S22, S13 as well. These four values, if you get, you can write the entire matrix. Because S33 is equal to 0, already we have wrote it before. So rest of the values, if you get, you can complete the entire matrix for H plane T junction. So let us see that. So what you have to do, write down the first equation. So to write the first equation, we have already seen in E plane T as well. Take the first row and the first column. So S11, S11 conjugate plus S12, S12 conjugate, S13, S13 conjugate is equal to 1. So S11, S11 conjugate can be written as S11 square. So S11 square plus S12 square plus S13 square is equal to 1. Similarly, second equation, second row multiplied by second column. Third equation, third row multiplied by third column. So all of you have completed first and second equation, and then you can go with the one more equation, fourth equation. So I think all of you might have completed till here. So if you have completed, you can just write the second and third equation and the fourth equation. So let us see. So we will get second equation as S12 square plus S22 square plus S13 square is equal to 1. And the third equation is S13 conjugate, S13 conjugate is plus 0 is equal to 1, or S13 square plus S13 square is equal to 1, or 2S13 square is equal to 1. So we get the equation 2S13 square is equal to 1. And fourth equation is S13 conjugate and plus S13 conjugate is equal to 0. These are the four equations we are going to use, and we are going to simplify it. So from the third equation, you can write S13 is equal to 1 by root 2, and then you need to compare equation 1 and 2. So you need to write the third equation, and from the third equation you will get S13 is equal to 1 by root 2, and then you need to compare equation 1 and 2. So all of you can compare the equations 1 and 2. So from equation 1 and 2, we can just find out the rest of the things. So by comparing equation 1 and 2, you can write that S11 is equal to S22 and give it as equation number 5. Then from equation 4, you know that S11 is equal to S22, and now you have to use this equation 4. And you need to simplify it further. So from equation 4, you can write it as S13 can be taken it outside, and S11 conjugate plus S12 conjugate, that in brackets is equal to 0. So S13 and these two parts, one can only be 0. So S13 cannot be 0. So S11 conjugate plus S12 conjugate has to be 0. So you can proceed further. So I think you might be still completing it. All of you have completed till equation 5. See, have you completed till equation 5?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, so further, when you simplify it, so what you're going to get, let us see. So we got S13 not equal to 0, S11 conjugate plus S12 conjugate is equal to 0, or S12 is equal to minus S11 conjugate. That is, you can write it as S12 is equal to minus S11, you can put it as equation number 6. So till now we got S11 is equal to S22, S13 is equal to 1 by root 2, and S12 is equal to minus S11. Now we'll go for further simplification, substituting equation 5 and 6 in equation 1. So all of you can substitute 5 and 6 in equation 1. So 5 is S11 is equal to S22 and 6 is S12 is equal to minus S11. So this 2 you substitute in equation number 1. Substitute equation 5 and 6 in equation 1. So when you substitute, what you are going to get? So you can just take equation 1 and substitute. So you will get S11 square plus S11 square plus 1 by root 2 whole square is equal to 1 you will get. So from that you can find out S11. So you can find out S11. So what is S11? Anyone of you got S11?
1/2, sir.
Okay. So you got 1/2. So S11 is 1/2. So 2S11 square is 1/2 and you will get S11 as 1/2. So you got S11 as 1/2. So from S11, you can find out S12 and you can also find out the other things like S22 and all those things. So what are the values for rest of the things? You can see that S12 will be equal to minus S11. We have written it before. So from that, you can substitute S11 and you can write S12 will be minus 1/2. And now you are left out with S22 maybe. So that S22 is S11. So S22 and S11 are same. So you can write it as S22 is equal to S11 is equal to 1/2. So now what you have to do is you have to write the S matrix. So all of you try writing the S matrix. Those who have not completed, just complete it off. Find out all the values of S11, S12, S22, S13. And substitute those values in the S matrix. So when you substitute the values in the S matrix, you are going to get matrix S is equal to 1/2, minus 1/2, 1/√2, minus 1/2, 1/2, 1/√2, 1/√2, 1/√2, and 0. So this is the S matrix representation for H plane T. So we got the two matrix representation, that is H matrix representation for E plane T, as well as S matrix representation for H plane T. So they will ask you to derive or find the S scattering matrix or S matrix representation for E plane T or H plane T or parallel series, anything they can say, additive T or subtractive. So based on the requirement of the question, you have to answer to those things. So it can be asked anything, and so you have to understand whether it is E plane or it is H plane, and then you have to simplify those things. So all of you have completed till here? All of you have completed the S matrix?
Yes, sir.
Okay, let us do a small problem and then we will go with just discussing about first and second module in brief. So this is what you can see, the problem. A 20 milliwatt signal is fed into one collinear port one and of a lossless. Here it is clearly mentioned that it is H plane T junction. So some places they may not say that it is H plane T, they may say that an additive or you may say subtractive. So you have to identify whether it is E plane or H plane, because that is the matrix you are going to use it further for simplification if required. So calculate the power delivered through each port when other ports are terminated in the matched load. So write down this problem. A small problem, but usually this is asked for university question paper as well as in internal question papers. So what you have to do is you need to study this thing properly. Sometimes the values might get changed, rather than that this remains the same. So you have to identify whether it is H plane or E plane and all those things. So this type of problems they usually ask. So you should get prepared. You mark it as important, this problem. We have maybe very limited problems in this module, and those problems keep repeating in the question papers. So from here onwards, you can see that here onwards the solution starts. So till here it is question. So you can see that some few values are given, like the signal fed into port one is given for you, and rest of the things they are asking you to find out the power at port one, port two, and port three. Everything you need to find out. So so you can just use the matrix representation of, if like S11 is required, means you can take it from the H plane, what is the value for S11, okay? So write down this question. So since port 2 and port 3 are matched, since the two ports are matched, we can take A2 and A3 as equal to 0, and you can, from the S matrix representation for H plane, you can write S11 is equal to 1 by 2. It is taken from the matrix, okay? So you can see just now you have written S11 is equal to 1 by 2. So this value. So this is what you are going to write. So what we have to find out is, see what they have asked is, calculate the power delivered through each port. So you need to find out the power delivered through each port, P1, P2 and P3, when other ports are terminated in the matched load. So you need to find out that and say that like port 1 you got 15, port 3 you got 10, and port 2 you'll be getting 5. So you have to say that the combination of port 3 and port 2 is same as that of port 1. So that is what we are going to do here. So port 2 and 3 are matched. So you can write S11 is equal to 1 by 2. Total effective power input to the port. So this equation you need to remember. That is power for port 1 is written as A1 square 1 minus S11 square. So value for S11 is known from the matrix. That is 1 by 2. You can just substitute that A1 is the input which is given. So you can see that the signal is fed into the, so 20 millivolts is the signal. So you can take that value here. So A1 square, so that they have given the power itself. So so this much millivolts of signal is fed. So you don't need to take any square of that. So A1 square itself is given for you is 20. So 20 into 1 minus S11 is already, it's not given anywhere, you know from the matrix. Okay. So you should write it here somewhere. S11 is taken from the matrix of S matrix of H plane T. So it will be helpful for you later on. Otherwise, you may think from where it came. So you have to substitute those values, 20 into 1 minus 0.5 square. So when you simplify it, you will get 15 millivolts. So this is what it is obtained at port 1. Similarly, this is the total effective power input. So what is the power input to the port 1? Now power we have to see at port 3. So the equation to do that, we have to use this equation port 3. P3 is equal to A1 square, S31 square. So A1 square is 20, the same one. S31 you have to take from the matrix. S31 we can see what is the value for S31. S31 is 1 by root 2. So you have to take that 1 by root 2 there and take square of that. So you will be getting the value for P3, power terminated, and that will be 10 millivolts. Still the problem is not completed. You have completed till here, you do it. Then we have to do the rest of the things as well and see that whether the input power is same as the power terminated at both the ports. We'll see that. One more thing we have to do, P2.
Sir, it should be yes, 3 whole square, sir.
Yes, which one?
P3 is equal to A1 square into S13 whole square, no, sir.
Yes.
1-3.
S13 or S31 is same because of the symmetric property. So I have written S31. Correct? No. So you see, S. We have already done that in the previous derivation. You see S. 1-3 you take or S31 you take, it is one and the same because of the symmetric property. So here we can write it as A1 square S31 square, and you can put it as 1 by root 2 square. We have studied Sij is equal to Sji. So all this 1-3, 3-1, 2-1, all these things will be all similar. So you'll get 21. All of you got 10 millivolts?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now to find out next one, you have to find out the power terminated to port 2. So the equation for that will be P2. P2 is equal to A1 square S21 square. So what will be A1 square is same as 20, and S21 you have to see from the matrix. What is S21? So take it from the matrix. It is minus 1 by 2. So when you take minus 1 by 2 square, it will be 1 by 2 square itself. So what you'll get, 20 into 1 by 2 square, you'll get 5 millivolts. So what you can understand here is the P1 is same as P3 plus P2. So what? So you can just note down this problem. In a H-plane T junction, one problem last time we have done in the previous class, continuation to that, In a H plane T junction, compute the power delivered to the loads 40 ohm and 60 ohm connected to arm 1 and 2. When 10 milliwatt of power is delivered to the matched port 3. So it is clearly mentioned that it is H plane T. So when it is clearly mentioned it is H plane T, so we are going to see the equations with respect to H plane T, and we are going to proceed further. It's not compulsory that they have to mention whether which plane T it is, but if it is not mentioned from by reading the question, you should be able to understand. They might have mentioned additive, subtractive and all those things. So those keywords you should understand which type of T it is. So this is the problem. We can continue in from the previous class. So write down this problem. In a H plane T, compute the power delivered to the loads 40 and 60 ohm connected in arm 1 and 2 when 10 milliwatt of power is delivered to the matched port 3. So you need to compute the power which is delivered. So you need to find out the power. So slightly we have to do this problem in a different way. So first what we know is it is H plane T junction. So let us write the equation for H plane T junction. That is what you have already found in the previous derivation for H plane T junction. Matrix S is equal to 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 1 by root 2 1 minus 1 by 2 1 by 2 1 by root 2 1 by root 2 1 by root 2 and 0. So this is the S matrix representation for H plane T. Now we will see that how this input power at port 3 and port 1 and 2 are going to be matched and how it can be done further. So all of you write down this question first. So all of you can just write down this question. Another 20 minutes will take, and then you have placement training. So we'll wind up after 20 minutes. Okay. So do this problem. So once you write the question, you just write the H plane S matrix for H plane T junction. And now let us see that how we can proceed further. So what we have to get here is P1, P2 is what? So what is the power generated through the port 1 and port 2? So the loads are 40 and 60 ohm respectively. So let us see that what we have to do is the input power at port 3 is already given for you. 10 milliwatts is given for you. So the input port power at port 3 is equally divided in port 1 and 2. So since the input at port 3 is 10 milliwatts, you can write it as 0.01. So 10 milliwatts can be written as 0.01 watts. Okay. So power towards port 1 and port 2 means you are going to divide it equally. So 0.01 will get divided equally means one port will have 0.05 watts, 0.005 watts. So how power can be written? We have already studied this equations. It can be written as half of B1 square and half of B2 square. So we know the equations for reflection power from port 1 and 2. This we have write it in terms of gamma. So reflection powers can be written as half of gamma 1 b1 square whole mod of that square, and another is half gamma 2 b2 square. So these two equations we are going to use and try to find out the parameters, and then we are going to simplify it further. So all of you complete till here, then we will solve the problem further. So here, very basic things what we have seen is, which is given in the question, port 3 has 10 milliwatts. So we have converted it into 0.01 watts. And you know that it will equally divide in port 1 and 2. So it is taken as 0.005 watts. So we have divided equally for port 1 and 2, and then we are going to use the equations and then simplify it further. So all of you have written the question. Have you completed the question?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So write that test matrix as well. Okay. So let us see that how it can be done. So we have power P1 can be written as so this is the entire thing, and you know that power in a port can be combination of incident and reflected power. So this is the equation for that. If you take one of the port, half of B1 square, and reflected power is half of gamma 1 B1 square. Whole means gamma 1 B1 modulus of that and square of that. Then what we can see is power at port 1, if you see P1 will be this power, that is half of B1 square minus of the reflected power. So whatever reflections takes place, we are going to reduce it. So the equation will be P1 is equal to half B1 square minus half of gamma 1 B1 square, and P2 will be half of B2 square minus of half of gamma 2 B2 square. So we have just written the equations here. So these are the two equations for power 1 and P1 and P2, that is port 1 and port 2, power for port 1 and power for port 2. So here you can see that there is gamma. So you already have studied the equation for gamma when Z1 and Z2 is given. So, and the characteristic impedance is what you have to assume it here. So you can just write down these two equations and then we'll move further. So here gamma has to be found out before proceeding with this equation to find out P1 and P2. So we have to find out gamma 1 and gamma 2. So here in this question, one very important thing what you have to understand here is the characteristic impedance Z0 is not mentioned in the question. And you cannot say that the question doesn't has Z0. It is like it's a very important fact what you have to understand is if the Z0 is not mentioned in the question paper or in question, you have the freedom to assume the characteristic impedance Z0 as 50 ohm. So you just note down that. So if the question paper is missed out with characteristic impedance, you can assume the characteristic impedance as 50 ohm. 50 ohm can be assumed in the, that is the standard, most of the standard characteristic impedance which is maintained. So we can assume that Z0 can be taken as 50 ohms. So let us have in the question, we have already seen that we have two terms Z1 and Z2. So we have the equation, the general equation for gamma. Gamma is ZL minus Z0 divided by ZL plus Z0. But here it is Z1 and Z2 is given. So we are slightly modifying the equation as Z1 minus Z0 divided by Z1 plus Z0 for gamma 1. And for gamma 2, we are going to write it as Z2 minus Z0 divided by Z2 plus Z0. So you need to find out gamma 1 and gamma 2. Here, most important thing is you need to assume the characteristic impedance Z0, and if it is not given in the question paper, if it is mentioned in the question paper, you should use the same Z0. So you have found out gamma. Once you find out gamma, it is just substitution of all these things in the equation for P1 and P2, and you can just understand what is the power obtained at P1 and P2. So first you find out gamma 1 and then you find out gamma 2, and then we will go ahead with that substitution. So half of B1 square is already known to you, it is 0.005. 0.005. So completed. So once you find out gamma 1 and gamma 2, then it is just substitution to find out power P1 and P2. So you will get P1 and P2 as well. So you got gamma 1 and gamma 2, all of you. What is the answer for this one? P1 and P2? So P1 you will get it as 0.005 into in brackets 1 minus 1 by 9 square. And P2 will be 0.005 into 1 minus 1 by 11 square. Have you completed this problem? Have you completed this problem?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is what you are going to get P1 and P2. So you can understand that there is a marginal difference between P1 and P2, and some of the power is being reflected. So there is a slight variation in with respect to P1 and P2, and so you will get 4.9383 and 4.9586. Okay, so this is what you are going to get, and this is that the power for port 1 and port 2. So further on, we have to study the next portion that is called as hybrid or magic tea. So you can just note down this topic, hybrid or magic tea. So what we have understood about hybrid or magic tea is the combination of E-plane and H-plane tea together. That is, you are going to merge. You have studied E-plane tea separate, you have studied H-plane tea separate. Now magic tea, the main logic of magic tea is that you are going to merge both the E-plane and H-plane together. So it is having not before E-plane was having three ports, H-plane was having three ports, so it was 3x3 matrix. But magic tea, since you are combining the E-plane and H-plane, it will be having four ports, and it will have both additive as well as subtractive properties. So you can see that the hybrid or magic tea will look like this. See, all of you should draw this properly. The best way of drawing this, I will tell you, don't see the entire figure. You can draw either E-plane first or H-plane first. Then you can draw the, if you are drawing E-plane, then you can draw the rest of the portion. If you are drawing H-plane, then you can draw the rest of the section. That one small block further. So you can just write down hybrid T or magic T. The combination of E-plane and H-plane T forms a hybrid T or called magic T, having four ports. So you can see that this is port 1, Kulinaram 1, Kulinaram 2, and you can take this as port 3, and you can take this as port 4. So this is port 4. It's not compulsory that you have to consider the E-arm to be third arm and H arm to be fourth arm, not mandatory. You can take H arm to be third as well as E arm to be fourth. When you do that, there will be a slight variation in the matrix representation what you are going to have in the S matrix representation. When you take arm 3 as E arm, arm 4 as H arm, you will get a different matrix. When you take arm 3 as H arm, and you interchange the arms number, you will get a different matrix, because it is S31, S32, S33, that portions and all, it will slightly vary when the when the arms are being interchanged. So the S matrix representation will be, you will be having two types of S matrix representation when you shuffle the numbers of each arm. So if we will see in this, we will try to take arm 3 as E arm and arm 4 as H arm.